Welcome back to the channel where we continue in Power BI, and today we are going to take a look at the table feature, which is called Add Columns. And you can create a new table inside Power BI that takes a related table, and you can add things for a customer like lifetime quantity purchased. We're going to take a look at that. We're going to take a look at lifetime value of the customer, the total amount of orders that that customer has by ID. And we're going to use the Add Columns function to create the additional table and the new column inside that table. So we're going to go to Power BI. It's very similar to the Select Columns feature, except this time we're adding in a new column in a new table. It's called Add Columns. Let's go to Power BI. Back in Power BI, and we're going to try out the Add Columns feature in DAX. We're going to create a new table, create a new column called Lifetime Quantity. And let's take a look at our data model. We have transactions data as a fact table. We have returns data as a fact table. Then we have some dimension tables: calendar, product, customers, and regions. Now, our customers table contains customer information, anything from customer ID, first name, last name, city. This is a good lookup table. It doesn't have any duplicates, and everything is connected by customer ID. So we are going to create a new table. And the new table, we are going to use the Add Column function to create a new table that adds the column in lifetime quantity. So we're going to call the table Add Column Lifetime Value, and it's going to equal, that's where we bring in the Add Columns function. And the Add Columns function is looking for a table, and the name of the table is going to be Customers. That is the current table that we have in the database. And then we are going to bring in the name. Now, this is the name that we want to call the new column. So we're creating a new column. We get to name it. And when you name a text column, you need to put it in parentheses. So we're going to call it Lifetime Quantity and Orders. And since this is Lifetime Quantity Bought, so that'll be the descriptive term in parentheses. Then we are now going to bring in the calculate function. And what we are going to calculate is the sum. We want the sum of the transactions data. We have a quantity column. So this adds all of the columns from that row. So we're going to close that out. And now we need to bring in the related table. And the related table is in the from customer to transactions data, that's the related table. So we're going from customer, and then the table that it's related to is transactions data. So when you add that in there, we're going to close out that parentheses, then we're going to close out the calculate, and then we're going to close out the add columns. So what we did is we added a new table called Add Columns Lifetime Value. We added the columns up from the customers table. We named the new column Lifetime Quantity Bought, and then we calculated out table name. And what we're going to get is a new table called Add Column Lifetime Value Demo. And when you look at this table, we now have the lifetime quantity purchased. And we can test this by, let's find a value, and let's find this one with 4 lifetime value bought. And the customer number is 6920. And we're gonna now go to the transaction table and look up 6920 for the customer ID. And when we look at their quantity purchased, we see quantity of 2 and a quantity of 2, which is a total of 4. So that gets you the quantity purchased on the Add Columns lifetime value. With the Add Columns feature, you can do additional columns, and all you need to do is just build out your table. So what we did from the original one, we currently have lifetime quantity bought. Now we're going to add orders. So we add in orders as the column name. Then we're going to count rows in the related table. And then we're going to bring in the transaction data as the related table. We close that out. And what that does is it creates an additional column. We currently had the first one, which was the lifetime bought. Now we have the orders, and we can double check this by looking for the first order, and that's 5137. And we go down to the transactions data, and the customer ID has one row in this transactions data column, and they purchased 4, and the total cost was $4.12. And when we go back up to the table, we see that they have 4 bought, 1 order, and that's customer 5137. So that's where you can take a look at and see how you can expand upon your add columns. It allows you to build additional tables and add some rows. I recommend you watching the select columns video that we did, because that is very similar, and the two, you can create either additional columns, you can create additional add columns, and you can either select columns by creating a new table inside Power BI. So definitely a lot of functions inside the table functions in Power BI. That's going to do it. Make sure to watch our recent video. We did some more DAX, additional DAX and data visualization as we continue to learn DAX and Power BI.